I'm gonna run my mouth after the song. Kids say the darndest things. Have you ever listened close to the games they play or the little songs they sing? Last night, dressed up in high heel shoes and wearing my old hat, my 4-year-old said, I want a divorce. And now, where did she hear that? Kids say the darnest things. Have you ever listened close to the games they play or the little songs they sing? Last night as I watched TV, one rushed through the door. Mommy, daddy's telling someone on the phone, don't you call me here no more. Kids say the darnest things. Have you ever listened close to the games they play or the little songs they sing? I bet my daddy can whip your daddy, but daddy's never home. I think mommy's worried about him because she cried all night long. Kids say the darnest things. Have you ever listened close to the games they play or the little songs they sing? You never know what they learn in school or what they're thinking of. My first grader just said a four-letter word and it sure wasn't love. Kids say the darnest things. Have you ever listened close to the games they play or the little songs they sing? Kids say the darnest things. Have you ever listened close to the games they play or the little songs they sing? Billy Sherrill and Glenn Sutton wrote that. Oh, Billy had his hand in a lot of stuff in his heyday. Tanya Tucker, and Tammy Wynette, and Shelby Lynn. Didn't he come out of retirement for Shelby? Just saying, I've done a lot of reading. Lord, if y'all would have known me back when I was in my preteen, teen, and 20s, Lord, I was a walking country music book. And I don't read up on it like I used to because I'm waiting for somebody to make me curious. But I'm not putting anybody down. But you know, it takes, there's something that always catches you with certain artists that they may make a mistake or two or something like that with picking songs and releasing. Sometimes it's not their choice. But anyway, you go, well, that weren't the best, but they gonna come back with something. You wait and see. They gonna come back and nail this. And they do. You stick it out with them. But this song here, that was the one about, bet my daddy could beat your daddy, but daddy ain't never home. That's part of my That's part of my life. Daddy cried, mama cried all night long. That's part of my childhood. Don't you call here no more is part of my childhood. That's when they get on the phone and all they can say is yes and no. Uh-huh and uh-uh. I ain't going to go in detail about everything. It's been a crazy week trying to detox from it. I've had some funny stuff happen this weekend. I've had some stuff that made me just want to run and forget everything. But I'm here. But I'm still thinking about running, but I'm going to retire first and just sell off everything and go sit on a sidewalk somewhere and sing, I guess. I don't know. There's probably better ways to handle that, wouldn't it be? I'm just talking off the top of my head and rambling. I probably should just take all of this off and just shut up and move to the next song. But I do make sense with a lot of stuff sometimes, but y'all just ain't here to hear it. And the reason I did this here jump, and it didn't hit me at the times I was doing it. Chuck Breeden, you say I'm a leaning, the leaning pitcher. I don't use my first name on YouTube, and that's why I didn't say it, because it's going both places. But I tell you, I've had some people to hunt me down from YouTube and lit my Facebook up with all the public stuff I had on there with the songs and all that stuff for people to hear, them little reels. And I'm like, woo, daddy. I never forget the first time somebody, I've done it. We've all done it. We find somebody that we like about, whether it's acting, singing, songwriting, whatever, and we just go through a lot of their stuff. We got a free moment. And I'm sitting there, and I'm not used to getting this attention. Especially one right after the other. And I'm like, oh, Lord. And it hit me a while back because I had done the song Sunday Morning Coming Down. And it had been like 3 weeks since I put it out for anybody to listen to. And then one weekend, I was cutting grass. And I'd come in and get me some water and check my phone. Oh, I'd go back out there on the porch and check my pulse and my breathing rate and all. And make sure I wasn't going to fall out and look like a swayback mule cutting the grass. My lawn pushmore now looks bow-legged. It does. Y'all ain't going to believe me, are you? You wait. No, I said all past 2 summers, I need to get a new lawnmower. Engine's fine. I put a new carburetor on it last year. But I paid somebody $60. I didn't know what was wrong with it the first time I messed up. I didn't want to deal with it. So I took it to somebody. And they charged me $60-some dollars and put a new carburetor on it. It's $30-some dollar part. Then they charged me. Guess what the part cost? They charged that in labor. I said, no more. Because I used to do all stuff like that. And I don't know why I'm not doing it now. It's like I ain't got a time for this. So when it started messing up last year, I said, well, I know what the problem is. And I took that thing off and got the numbers I needed off of it. Went to the hardware store, bought another carburetor. Come home, put it on, and it's all nice and good. But that lawnmower looks bow-legged. I need to cut my front yard now. I saw a man cutting grass yesterday with a pair of jeans on and a short sleeve shirt. And I said, watch, today I have to cut grass because it's getting the best of me with all these freaking weeds coming up. Looking, one weed looks like a tobacco plant. It's next to the road. I got a ditch between my front yard and that. I'm losing yard with erosion. But I said, watch, today I have to cut grass. I'm going to put a coat on. It won't stay on me long. As soon as I be out there about 5 minutes, I'll be pulling that thing off and coming in the house, take the pants off and put a pair of shorts on. And my legs will be so dead blame white, a plane might land. Never know. I didn't used to be this white. I used to stay tanned all the time. I don't do that anymore. The place I like to go to is no longer around. And I can't get her to do another. But it was right there at me, convenient, right price and all of that. Heather, I know you're watching. At least you say you do. Don't let me act like I got some sense. Because she don't send me a message. Bye, y'all, and be nice.